Tony Bellew says that Deontay Wilder will crush and knock out Tyson Fury in 3 rounds or less. Stay tuned. Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. What up, Fight World? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. If you want to become part of the gang, notification gang, please hit the bell icon. Shout out to the Super Chats, channel donations, the Venmo donations, and the Patreon family. We work in Sky Sports. Shout out to them. Link in the description. Title reads, Tyson Fury will be knocked out by Deontay Wilder inside of 3 rounds, says Tony Bellew. They have an exclusive interview with Bellew, and it's Bellew's belief that Tyson Fury will lose to Deontay Wilder if that fight is made, if he obviously gets past Francisco Pineda. He says, and I quote, "At the minute, it's a bit of a freak show with Tyson Fury, but to be fair, he's been out of the ring for the best part of 3 years, and he hasn't lived the best lifestyle. So you can't expect him to come back into the sport and this business and take on top competitors. He is definitely not ready for Deontay Wilder. Pineda is 6'5", 17.5 stone southpaw. How is that preparing him in any way, shape, or form for a 6'7", possibly the biggest puncher in the whole world?" Right? He says, "I don't think he'd ever beat Wilder. Styles make fights, but when you're talking about Wilder, no one knows what he is going to do because he doesn't know either. I always thought David Haye would beat Fury because of the styles. Tyson Fury is a vulnerable heavyweight. There's no two ways about that. He is not a big man who can absorb anything and everything. He is vulnerable and he can be hurt. And when you are coming across guys with the speed and explosive power like Deontay Wilder and David Haye, it isn't good. Fury against Wilder would be over in 3 rounds at the most." So that is the fight prediction officially from Tony Bellew. Now, Tyson Fury and Bellew have had an exchange of words and talked about fighting each other. And he's saying he's been out of the ring, he's inactive, and styles make fights. Listen. More and more is coming into the picture. Ego's Army, new media. I'm going to keep repping. I'm going to keep banging. I put the bay on my back, the whole west side, and we rode. And now you see more and more people saying a lot of similar things that I've been saying. And like, just stuff like Wilder's is finally starting to get some of the credit. Like, people keep saying that he's wild and windmill, but why are people failing drug tests to fight Wilder? They're, "Oh, he's windmill, he has chicken legs, he has a bum resume." Why are champions who have done work in multiple divisions, light heavyweight, cruiserweight was a champion, heavyweight just beat David Haye twice, guys like Tony Bellew vouching for Wilder and saying, "You know what, Wilder, I think he'll beat the former lineal champion Tyson Fury." You know what I mean? So nobody's corroborating all that old media bullshit that you guys are used to hearing about, "Oh, windmill Wilder." You know, why are people not saying that? Why is Luis King Kong Ortiz, he's not really saying that. He's saying Anthony Joshua is ducking Wilder. He's not saying Wilder has no power, right? So obviously, listen, when you got people in the industry, particularly in the division and stuff, and they're all saying the same thing, maybe you should take heed to that. As far as Tony Bellew, I like him, real man's man type. And he might fight Usyk, Alexander Usyk. That's no slouch or pushover. It's the undisputed champion of the world. He looks like he's willing to flex his weight, fight at heavyweight, cruiserweight. He's just trying to get work. So I respect it. I respect Tony Bellew's opinion, and not just because I believe or agree with him, but I just think he's a stand-up dude. You know, we're not always probably going to agree on certain topics, but I don't know if Wilder will get Fury out of there in three, though. Just because Fury's a big man, and you know, Wilder had a slow start versus Luis King Kong Ortiz. You got to get in your groove, especially a focused Tyson Fury, his size, his frame, his herky jerky movement, feints, and stuff like that. Then I don't know. I think it's a good fight. It's good for boxing, nonetheless. It's a hell of a consolation prize to the Joshua Wilder fight not happening as it should have this year. Let me know if you agree with Tony Bellew's prediction, and do you want to see the Usyk Bellew fight? Drop your thoughts in the comment section. Let me know who wins that one. Make sure you smash the like button as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video is Ego signing off. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.